Hello, hello everybody, and welcome to another episode of XCOM Longer Impossible. I'm Falek, and today we are taking over an alien abductions in India in Lucknow. Well, is that a city, really? Okay. And I probably mispronounced the name terribly, I've never heard of that city before. Anyway, we are going on a roadway map, so I'm coming in long range heavy. Even Zhang, who comes with a shotgun, is really a long-range specialist with a hitter, gather specialist, and the hit and run perk. So we have three marksman rifles, we have Gonzalez as a healer, we have Midshield, who's gonna come in and punch shit, and we have, well, basically a pretty nice all-around stationary fuck-em-up squad. What are we going to do with them depends on where are we going. And yes, I know we are going to India.
The area of engagement for this mission will be in India. We've picked up a local broadcast indicating alien activity within a major metropolitan area. We should get down there and eliminate any hostiles.
Yes, sir, Bradford, sir. No, wait, I'm your boss. Shut up, I'm giving the orders here. So, what's gonna happen is we are going to set up our snipers and scouts in position, we are going to pull the enemies with, and then we are going to basically pin them down with laser fires and make them hurt. Make them hurt a lot and then some more. We have plenty of explosives, plenty of everything, so this should be an easy mission. But, of course, I may and probably will be surprised more than once during it. Because I very often am. I didn't bother in grappling hooks because there is nothing to grapple towards to. And I don't know what my enemies are going to exactly be. Oh, fuck. Oh fuck.
Central, Big Sky in position on approach of the abduction site. Strike One is awaiting drop clearance.
Copy that, Big Sky. Strike One is cleared to engage hostile targets.
Okay, so... So we have a landing zone activation. We have three berserkers and a muton. And I have no cover for everybody. So the only choice I really have is to take Wally, Shredder Rocket, activate the pod with it. Then I'm going to kill the muton and we'll see how it's going to look like, whether or not I'm gonna try to overwatch the berserkers or kill them. I would set up overwatch traps right away, but I'm afraid I will be risking activations and I don't want to count on the RNG in that matter. So, I'm going to make a great risk right now. Everybody's got shredded. Muton took a very, very bad cover for himself. I'm glad and happy that it happened like this. Okay, so what we have to do right now is pretty simple. I'm going to take Koal and he is going to eliminate the Muton. Because somebody gotta do it, so better get this over with. And now cover doesn't matter. What matters is my capability to dish damage. Which might, just might not be enough. Can I get my people far enough that it doesn't matter? I do not think so. They will get me whatever I do. So I'm going to pick a target. And Rosario is not gonna be opening the line with that bad aim. She has to wait until we are closer to that. How about you, Chilong?
Moving to position.
You have a close combat specialist. Awesome chance to hit, take it away. 14 damage, this is badass. Hope nobody panics. Do not
I don't want to die like this!
Like really? You of all people, Zhang. You should know better. We still can't risk shooting that guy.
Affirmative.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna... Oh yeah, this is boss.
Hostiles pacified.
This is boss, this is better than I could possibly have hoped for, which means I have 1, 2, 3, 4 shots to deal with them. I'm gonna leave one for laters. Well, no, I can't, but I can't kill him either. Well, take it away. Theoretically, I could maybe kill this guy with a fist, especially since now we have people panicking all over the place. So I'm going to try. Fist should do up to 14 damage, especially since this guy is shredded. Gotta make it work, man. Gotta make it work, mid-shield. There we go. This is great. This is awesome. Yoga fire, yoga flame. We got that guy. Okay, so I have to protect my people. The Berserker can probably get them no matter what I do. So maybe I can convince him to shoot a mech instead. I mean, to attack a mech instead of everybody else. This would be the best. And in any case, wounds would be reducing its mobility, I hope. So yeah, I hope. That is the only thing I can do. I hope that it's gonna attack the mech now. Rosario doesn't even have to bother shooting with that terrible aim. See? That was a waste of bullets.
Blanco fallado.
Los daños son leves.
And we made it. It hit the mech. So it turns out that those berserkers were harmless after all. However, we have lots of panicking people and Zhang, I bet you feel silly right now. Like, seriously. Panicking. I expected more from a Triad veteran. There you go, now you are better.
No longer a threat.
That made me feel much better about you, Zhang.
I have no ammo. I can't engage.
So, we managed to kill the pod, and that means it's time to reconfigure the squad, reload the guns, and move on.
Got it.
And let's not mention those silly panics to anybody. Luckily, it wasn't all that bad. We could have it much, much worse. Trust me when I say this, it could have been much worse. So now Anna is going to spray everybody with a suspicious white liquid. White liquid, I'm sorry. And then we will be ready to go.
Rock and roll.
Everybody has been sprayed. They are going to have to clean the smears of the armor themselves. And it appears my enemies are gonna be floaters. And more mutants or berserkers. So this is what I want to do preferably. Preferably I want to get my snipers safely into the truck. They can use it as a very nice cover. I want to have the guy with a normal sniper rifle completely in the back. There is no real need to risk his life for anything. Zhang is gonna swap his shotgun to a heater because now he's gonna be fighting long range. Wally can somehow get into full cover over there. That's gonna be very good for him. Plenty of room to shoot rockets, and they are javelin rockets, which mean that they can have much greater distance and accuracy than normal ones.
Recargando armas.
So from there, Wally can probably shoot wherever on the battlefield. We'll see next turn. Rosario is gonna join up. Wengel has a marksman rifle, so he can move out with the rest of the squad. He also has a disarming shot, which is a very important. Yana, the scout, can come up and reload. She also has a marksman rifle, so she's a long-range fighter, but not as long-range as a sniper rifle. And the Echo can use steady weapon. He is gonna get psionically trained as soon as there is a free spot, and then we will have a psi inspiration, which is a very good thing on him. Indeed, what that could have possibly been? Let me guess, aliens? So I'm gonna have Ayana, and she is gonna throw a battle scanner. Because even though I doubt my snipers can do it, there is a very good chance that Wally can get the rocket where it needs to be. There we go, we see a pod of chrysalid and heavy floaters, really? That's what I'm seeing? That's a very weird pod. We see floaters, heavy floaters and chrysalids, all in one pod. Dr. Attenborough should probably write something about this. Okay, so I can very easily fuck him up with a normal rocket or with a shredder. I believe that with the Ranger, normal rocket has a chance to kill the small floaters, so let's try this. If not, I just don't want to waste a shredder. So what did happen? We hit all four of them. No casualties. They are not feeling all that happy about it anyway. So, now, can we see the heavy floater? We see the normal floater, we see the normal floater, and we see this. Okay, so the heavy floater will remain elusive for this turn, I believe. But this guy isn't gonna fly far. I am going to take my power fist and I am going to stomp that cockroach. Yep, that's what I'm gonna do. Da-da-da-da-da-da! Flying chrysalids! Oh, it survived. Well, party poopers. This guy's alive, this guy's alive, this guy is too far away. So I guess Vengir can just kill this guy. I mean, the floater. Bye bye. See ya. I don't wanna be ya. I can hopefully get a shot at the heavy right now. If it hits, it's gonna be great. If it doesn't, I'm gonna provide my, the heavy floater with a target. And a mech is always better to, you know, be shot at than somebody else, right? So. Zhang is gonna go into cover, he should have a nice shot. Okay, let me just make sure that Rosario can finish off the pesky creature. Which he was not supposed to be alive. You are shitting me. Okay, Zhang is gonna have to run and gun, turn around and shoot the fucking chrysalid. Come on, Rosario. Come on.
Target neutralized.
So now the heavy floaters is gonna have a chance to throw a grenade at me or shoot the ambulance. Thank you, Rosario Arena. You are my favorite person right now, and you better die during this mission, because if not, you are cleaning all the dishes. And only because it missed. Otherwise, you would also be cleaning the floors. And toilets with your own toothbrush. So let's try to take a shot with a sniper. We have none. But we have Yana Kalashnik in a very nice position, so we will make use of her. To put a holo target on this heavy floater, but that hardly seems necessary at the moment. And since we have that normal floater acting like a little bitch and hiding over there, I'm gonna have Zhang just perform a triad style execution on it.
I need to reload. The mark is down.
And he's gonna reload like a boss. Come on, you were supposed to do it like a boss, not like a little baby.
Bien.
Are you a baby, Zhang? Do you want me to change your diapers? Okay, I'm gonna stay by that column, because jokes aside, this is the best place for me right now. Since I have to reload and I'm already seeing more than half the map. Vengils is going to catch up. I strongly believe that Wally can stay where he is right now and will probably have very good shots at everything. Because we still have rockets, you know, one shredder, one normal one. Okay, we hear more floaters in their natural environment. So, let's cause them some discomfort. Come on, Yana. You don't wanna find them for me? Well, that's fine. Since this is the case, I can, I think, safely toss up a battle scanner to see if the road to the meld is free. She's completely in the open, but we see no enemies. There you go. So as long as we don't activate them, we'll be fine. And of course we can activate them right now. This is so, so nice. Okay, so what kind of a pod is it? It's a pod of 1, 2, 3, 4 normal floaters. Gonna be a good fight in next turn. But for now, let me just get my people a little bit closer.
Been unterwegs.
Just to make sure I don't activate them. Because I have a scout in completely in the open and there is no way I'm killing all four this turn. Let's see if Rosario can get to somewhere useful. Not from where she's standing, so let's move her a little bit. Vengil is probably have some very nice shots, but let's move him to the other side of the road anyway, just so that we have every corner of the map covered with a sniper fire. Wally. Wally is just short of his rockets hitting the mark, and I want to activate the pod with him, so off you go.
Ojo visor, comandante.
Zhang is there. And he can join everybody else. Watching for I have to build a heavy pistol for Zhang, I mean a heavy Gauss pistol. And if the floaters decide to walk into me right now, the overwatchers should get them dead. There you go, that is very nice. Assuming we hit them. Okay, we hit one, we hit the second. And that's only three overwatchers, so... Okay, one is overwatching in the back, and there is a pod of 4 mutants. Not active yet. But good to know, I have to get rid of those floaters right away in that case. And get prepared, right? So, Yana... Yes, yes it is. Yana can holo-target the flying one for me. So that it's an easier kill. 197. Take a 97.
No longer a threat.
Very nice kill. So since the mutants are coming out of a very unexpected direction, Wall is gonna move again rather than shoot. I want to be able to fuck him up with a rocket. And that's final.
Marchando.
Ana Gonzalez can move up on this floater because the mutants are on the other side. Thank you, holo-targeting. That means one floater is overwatching and nothing I can do about that. Except maybe moving Zhang, but that would get him hit by the overwatchers and that would suck.
Moving.
So Zhang is gonna get in position where he can shoot his own overwatch at the mutants. Alongside Mitchell, right over here, see what I'm doing. If the mutants continue on the course they are on right now, they should be crossing that gate. and then they will be fired by the overwatchers. I don't think this is happening this turn. I'm only overwatching this turn because I want to catch the last floater. Which actually made me realize that I'm kinda silly to do it like this. Not a good idea, because now Zhang is in the open, and if the overwatchers miss, then Zhang is fucked. But I don't think this is gonna be happening. Oh, there is even more. What? The X-rays. Teleporting Lizard. Aliens. Gotta love this bug. Gotta handle it somehow. So yeah, I'm not gonna make it a huge and terrible deal. As long as they are not shooting me on activations, I can handle it. I think it's time to hurry up to pick up the meld. Zhang, can you reach it? Can you kill it? Can you get it for me? And yes, he can, so he will.
Understood.
The worst thing that could possibly happen is to get shot by Overwatch. And I don't think this is the case, because we moved away from there. We have two shots. So this should be an easy kill. Unless Zhang panics again. What? No, no. Oh, right, run and gun and hit and run don't work together. My bad. So what I am going to do right now is I'm gonna have Wally. That would be such a waste, though. But shooting those guys would be a waste, too. Choices, choices. Anyway. I'd rather shoot them than fuck them up with a rocket, because that gives me corpses. And corpses I can exchange with the council for something useful. So yeah, the teleporting bug is rather annoying, but it is seriously not the worst thing that could possibly happen. It's not even close on the list. I don't think it's even on the list, especially in a situation like this. When the alien teleport just puts them in a position where they are dead. So, then we have a wounded mutant and a floater to worry about instead of what was before. I hardly call that a terrible bug. I call that taking away my pleasure of killing them. Because now it's easy.
And it is boring.
Okay, we have 83, 28, easy choice, easy money. That leaves me with one alien on the map. It only has like 3 hit points. And the only reason it will possibly survive this turn is because I can't get it.
Ich steige auf.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to activate the jet boots and get in position to finish the mission with a joyful power fist from the sky. Boom! Or actually no, I just want the mutant to shoot Brutal Barbarian. I admit, I'm brutal like that. I'm a real terrible person. So if Yana cannot get the hit, and she will not, then I want the Barbarian to get shot at. It's better than any of the alternatives. Except maybe this one. That's okay. He's very wounded. I fear nothing about the lightning reflexes. Yana Kalashnik is gonna come up. She's gonna take a shot. It's a miss, but that's fine. Anybody who has a shot can now finish it off. I don't really care about the power fist from the sky, I just wanted to make sure that the alien is threatened enough so that it doesn't throw a grenade at me. And yes, the operational objectives are completed. That was, as I said, easy, straightforward mission, gotta love the roadway maps. There was only one really scary moment at the beginning, but we figured it out and it was no problem. And here we are, back at the base. We are
not leaving any question as to our ability to fight the alien threat. Excellent work all around, Commander.
You're welcome, Shen. So yeah, for Rosario it is going to be Danger Zone, I believe. I'm gonna wait with it, because I can't remember, because Rosario is the experimental build that Brutal Barbarian wanted me to test. It's the bullet wizard kind of thingy. I had to take hit ammo, that was obvious because I don't want any gunner that doesn't have hit ammo. But other than that, we are following it to the letter, so I'm gonna check it out. I don't remember what was next, you know. And we got 10 melts, some alloys, some money.
Remember, we will be watching.
That's fine, watch all you want. We are about to finish the cyberdisc autopsy, and that means we are about to get our dodge consumables. There we go, assign new research. That's lots of stuff. We have defense matrix dodge, which we want. Sentinel drone. I want that very much. That's a foundry project I'm starting right away. It makes shifts absolutely boss. I don't know what that is. Ah, I'm gonna build that. Hey, that's nice. Iron skin. I don't really care about gene mods all that much. So what do? I have to start the sectoid commander autopsy some point, but I want to get the faster stuff done first. Because it is faster. And Ellerium is also an important part on our way to a better power systems and better interceptors altogether. But it's time for perhaps a chrysalid autopsy. It's been long delayed and it would give me some interesting things
to build. Based on what we've seen in the field so far, including several grotesque examples of trauma resulting from the emergence of its young, we've taken to calling this specimen a chrysalid.
Oh, really? Well, I've taken to calling them bugs, because it's easier to say. And let's get going. Oh, right, let's not get going, let's get the foundry projects done. Bloody hell. So, what we have to do? We have to get the Sentinel drone, which requires more UFO flight computers, so can't get it right now. Super Sky Ranger is important. Might take it. Salvage, not so much. I might only get it if I want to have some particular Steam achievements. Like, what else would I do it for? And yeah, I don't care about Steam achievements at all. Okay, so this would be nice. This would be very, very nice. I just need more money for that, and I'm unwilling to sell anything. So that means the only thing I'm actually doing is getting the thing that I wanted, defense matrix dodge. I want 3, because I want 3 of everything, but I don't have enough cyber disc racks because I keep blowing them up. So I'm gonna build 2. That's what you get when you blow up your enemies. And aim uplink, I need more of those. That's right. I'm using them all the time, so there is never a dull moment with those guys. Let's just scan for activity. Necovert Destroyer. Can we get it? We have Puke with a laser cannon. We are going to try, because it's bombing to raise panic, so I'm gonna go for a balanced approach. Fuck him up as much as I can, and if he survives, I'm going to send the Stingrays to kill it off.
We're in pursuit.
I am going to, of course, use the aim targeting. Come on, you can do it. You will not get hit.
We're getting eaten up here.
You will not get hit, come on. There you go, you shot it down. Perfect. And that means we have another try at the capturing of the fucking outsiders. I'm stubbornly gonna do it every single opportunity I have, and I will fail miserably one time after another, but eventually I will get done. And then we can take back South America, okay? So, thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed this pretty nice and smooth alien abduction, and I'm looking forward to see you watching the next episode, when I will be cursing under my breath and wanting to throw my keyboard out the window while I'm failing at capturing the outsiders. Thank you for watching, see you again next time, bye bye!